All right. My name's Mookie, or Mark, if you prefer. Either one will do, from the Independent 88.5 FM here in Southern California. I've been looking forward to this for quite some time. We had this interview on the books for several weeks now, and the time is here. Jensen McCray is in the Zoom room with us today. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's my pleasure. So we discovered you by accident, like so many others probably recently.
Yeah.
I saw a Phoebe Bridgers tweet online, again, for the uninitiated. We saw a Phoebe Bridgers tweet of you. She retweeted you performing a song, and I'm paraphrasing here, but you said that this is a song that Phoebe Bridgers would probably write in the year 2023. And it was a version of the song Immune. You know, immediately I found that, I saw it, I emailed some of your people, and we've played the songs White Boy and Wolves on the Air a little bit. And then you hit us with the actual full version of the song Immune. And last week on the air, that was the second most spun song on our radio station.
Oh, wow.
So happy to introduce our listeners to the music of Jensen McCray. First question for you was it just a snippet of that song which was done and ready to go? And then did you finish that song afterwards because of the demand?
Yeah, I just kind of in like 10 minutes, a couple hours after sending the original tweet, I decided to write like what a bit of what I thought the song would sound like. And then when that got even more traction, I very quickly like finished the rest of it and sent it off to my producer to turn it into what it is now.
You talk about your producer. Who is that? And what's your working relationship like with that person?
His name's Rocky, and we met in the fall of 2018. My current manager, Kristen Gregory, found me on Instagram and booked me for a show. And after I performed in that show, she sent my music to him because they've been friends for like 15 years. And he and I started working together almost right away. And it's just been like an incredible journey to like of me finding my sound under his tutelage. Like it's been incredible, like growing so much as an artist and as a writer with him.
And you are a born and bred Angeleno, from what I understand, a product of the San Fernando Valley, like myself. I was reading, Chatsworth High School over here. What about you?
I went to Harvard Westlake.
Right on. And you studied at USC, right? Did you study music?
Yeah, I was a popular music major at the Thornton School of Music there and graduated in 2019.
So what came first for you? Was it creative writing or poetry, or was it always music?
I think it was kind of simultaneous. When I was really little, I was singing all the time, but I was also a really early reader and a really voracious reader. And so when I showed an interest in pursuing music as a career at a very early age, my mom told me that the money was in the writing. And so she encouraged me to learn how to play piano. That was my first instrument, and to pursue songwriting and all my other creative writing passions. So I've kind of been doing them all for as long as I can remember and like as long as I could read.
And again, we just found you because of, you know, you going viral. But you've been an active writer and songwriter and musician for a number of years now. And, you know, after seeing that first Phoebe Bridgers tweet, you know, I went down the rabbit hole of Jensen McCray. And I love, you know, looking at your YouTube page. It seems like you are engaging your fans. And whether that's playing music or just having a sort of a dialogue up on there. Recently, just a day ago as we record this, you kind of posted a spoken word, sort of poetic diatribe, if that's the term, called Black Girl Culture. And you even had said that you've written 6 novels in your lifetime in the past. None of them have been published quite yet, though, huh?
No, not yet. That's something that I hope to do probably in between albums. But yeah, when I was a senior in high school, for whatever reason, I set myself the challenge to write a manuscript and a feature film and a collection of poetry. And up until 2020, I did that like every year, like 5 years in a row. And then in 2020, I wrote the novel, but the screenplay and the poetry collection didn't quite come together. I'm going to give myself some grace for the fact that there was a pandemic. But yeah, I've always been sort of a self-diagnosed hypergraph. I can't help but be writing pretty much all the time.
What's your comfort zone as far as like the subject matter when you sit down and write, I guess, either a song or a novel?
I write a lot about just like the general travails of adolescence, I guess. Like I'm 23, so like I'm kind of, I guess adolescence is over now, but I'm very consumed with like the process of coming of age and the transition from like childhood and innocence into adulthood. And I talk a lot about mental health and unrequited love. I feel like those topics are kind of where my interests tend to fall, like regardless of what medium I'm in.
How's the pandemic been treating you? How big is your bubble? And it seems like you might not even have time for leisure activities because, you know, just me looking from the outside in, it looks like you're incredibly active, like working on music and all sorts of things. Is there any free time?
There's definitely free time. I'm a pretty efficient worker. So like I definitely spend time writing and creating every single day, but I'm pretty efficient with my time. So there's plenty of time to like scroll through TikTok. But yeah, my bubble's pretty small. It's mainly just me. But also I see my parents, like if I've been isolating for long enough, I haven't really done any socializing at all, even outdoors, since like November. The only time I leave my house now is if I'm working or I'm like going to the grocery store. Mm-hmm. So I've been doing a lot of Zoom and FaceTime parties and hangs, and that's probably my main leisure activity, is like FaceTiming with my friends and just talking about like astrology and pop culture.
How are you consuming music? Are you streaming? Are you playing vinyl? And what are some of the artists that you've been digging on lately?
Yeah, I'm a streamer. My team just got me a record player for Christmas. So I'm going to get into that soon. I'm going to set that up with my speakers. But yeah, I mean, I'm definitely a big streamer. I really love SZA. I've been listening to a lot of SZA lately. Of course, Phoebe Bridgers. I go back to Sarah Bareilles a lot. She was like my comfort artist for all of middle school and high school, and I've been going back to a lot of the artists I listened to when I was younger, like her and Kryn Bailey Ray and John Mayer and all those people, because when you're in like such a tumultuous political and social climate, like to return to like the soundtrack of your youth, you can kind of pretend it's not happening anymore. So I've been doing a lot of that.
Right, not necessarily regressing, but there's maybe a comfort regressing. Zone. Well, I mean, right. Well, I mean, I got a lot more questions here, but you do have that that guitar, and as you mentioned, sort of off the air, you know, the room that we see behind you is where the magic happens.
Yes.
As far as
bedroom / studio.
Right. So, what'd you want to play for us today?
The first thing I'm going to play is a song that's been out for almost exactly a year now, which is so crazy to think about, but it's called Wolves. And yeah, I'm going to start with that, I guess.
Appreciate that so much. This is Jensen McRae, and you can hit it whenever you want.
Okay. I was 15, still in the valley, walking in a parking garage. First time I met a wolf in person. At first I thought it was a dog. Tried to dodge him, he was faster than I'd ever had to be. He smiled and howled in the same moment, and knocked the wind right out of me. Got away. I never walked the same. Mm-hmm. Now I bury my smile and show no interest. Now I carry myself a little different. Now I avoid the woods. Now I know the still fun at parties. He plied me with shot after shot. He assured me he was harmless. Why did I ever trust a fox? I ignored all of my teachings. How I survived, I can't believe. right away. I never walked the same. Now I bury my smile and show no interest. Now I carry myself a little different. Now I avoid the woods. Now I know who. Saw a teenage girl on my street, talking tall to one of them. Recognized him in an instant. Heard about him from my friends. Thank God women learn to whisper. But I crave a megaphone. That wolf said it's dangerous out there. That wolf said let me walk you home. Now I bury my smile and show no interest. Now I carry myself a little different. Now I avoid the woods. Now I know the
incredible. The I guess the 88.5 FM debut, or I guess our own version of the song Wolves by Jensen McRae. Love hearing that right here in the Zoom room. I feel like I know you personally, by the way, because of all of the content I've seen on the internet.
Maybe you know too much.
not enough, I would say. Again, our listeners have heard the song Immune on the air and Wolves and White Boy on the local music spotlight feature on the midday show. Now, those are all songs that might be included in a full-length record available sometime this year. Is that right?
Yeah, there's Immune was kind of a bonus track kind of moment. But yeah, Wolves and White Boy are definitely part of a larger project that's coming later this year. I don't know how much I'm supposed to say.
Well, no, that's cool. Say no more. I imagine it's pretty gratifying to be able to have a say in putting together a full-length record, as well as the visual aspect of the album art. Have you thought about that quite yet?
Yeah, we've been having a lot of creative brainstorming sessions, like internally, like just with my team, and also with the label, just like figuring out all of the various pieces that are going to be coming together for the singles and for the rest of the projects that are coming.
Man, we can't wait to see it all sort of come to fruition, and we'll be right there with you. It's amazing to see you on this upward trajectory right now. But of course, pre Phoebe Bridgers tweet. you were quite active in the arts, and do you miss playing gigs? What are some of your favorite venues around SoCal, and where did you start playing in front of people?
That's an interesting question. I'm not totally sure where my like very first gigs were. I got really serious about gigging when I was in college, like probably my second year. I played a coffee shop in Alhambra, played Hotel Cafe a lot, played there like dozens and dozens of times.
That's just a great hang. And that's one of the places that I really miss, because I would go and hang out there just on any given night, not knowing who would be playing, just because it's a good hang, you know?
It's a great hang. And so many of my friends have like found their mentors and bandmates through just sheer accident playing shows there. And so many great opportunities have arisen as a result of me being there, whether I'm playing to a packed house or there's like two people in the audience and the bartender. Like it's always really, really fun, and it always leads to something cool.
You know, it was really pretty magical for us is we had an event there with Dawes in the past and the band Vintage Trouble, which was just a crazy good performance packed to the gills. Those bands started out at World Cafe, you know, and all of a sudden they're blowing up and they're huge all over the country, if not the world. And to come back and to be able to play that venue, I guess a venue that gave so much to them when they were first starting out, to kind of have it see it become full circle, is just it gives you goosebumps, you know?
Yeah, it's a there's so many places that I want to play too. Like right before the pandemic really kicked into gear, I saw Theo Katzman, an artist I discovered through Hotel Cafe, play the Fonda with one of my good friends, Rhett Madison, and another incredible musician who opened for him. I would love to play the Fonda one day. The Wiltern's kind of like my big dream LA venue. Yeah, there's so, I mean, obviously there's so many incredible places to play music around here.
Yeah, Theo Katzman from Wolfpack.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, incredible band who doesn't need radio airplay. They just do it on their own with their, I guess, grassroots movement. This is Jensen McCrae. People could find you on the internet, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. I guess if they just search for Jensen McCrae, that should probably get you to where you need to be.
Yeah, I'm the only one in the whole world. So if you search my name, I'll come up.
Speaking of live music and playing in front of people, did you ever feel, I mean, because songwriting could be so personal. Did you ever feel apprehensive to get up in front of people and share your music?
I've definitely had that fear a couple of times. A lot of the best songs that I write are the most personal ones. White Boy, which was my first single, was like one of the songs I was most afraid to play because I felt like it was too niche of an experience. I didn't think anyone else would really relate to it. But of course, that did not happen. I had a lot of people reaching out, either saying that they hadn't experienced it, but their eyes were opened to that particular paradigm. And then there were the people who had gone through the same thing and had never heard it expressed musically before. So I definitely get worried before playing really personal things, but then seeing the response of other people, you know, acknowledging the same experiences makes it all worth it.
Yeah, isn't it crazy? Music, man, you could write something that that's about your life that you're experiencing, and then you know, you could have 100 people listen to the song, and they could take out maybe even something different, or understand where you're coming from and relate. It's like looking at a piece of art in a museum. You know, 100 people could take away something different. Or see exactly where the artist was coming from. It's crazy. Music is magical, man. I was looking online and it looks like there's this webinar coming with someone who's goes by the name of Jay Irving. I don't know who that person is, but what is that webinar about, and what are you going to be talking about?
So Jay is the head of human resources, which is where I am signed. They recently were acquired by The Orchard at Sony, and me and Jay are just going to be having a discussion about art and music, and I imagine Black History Month a little bit because we're still in that month. Just going to be kind of talking about all of the journey that I've been on and the journey he's been on and the culture, kind of the nature of it.
Cool. So people could find you. I mean, I found out about that via your Twitter feed, going
I'll
back to Twitter again.
Yeah.
Right on. People could sign up for that webinar on the internet right now. Can we get another song?
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool. Awesome. What do you want to play next?
I'm going to play Immune now. Do a little live version. I'm going to tune up while I get ready. But yeah, this has been a very unexpected musical journey. Like, there was a lot already queued up for this year for me in terms of rollout, and to have this song become a part of that journey and to bring so many new people in has been like a really, really great accident. So excited to play it for you guys.
Incredible.
Now.
Incredible.
Traffic from the side got me aggravated, harder than the day my brother graduated. Wait for hours in the sun in line at Dodger Stadium. I'm not scared if dogs are getting vaccinated. Lay the seat back, turn this place into a bed. Someone smoking in the camera just ahead. Yeah, I know the irony would never be lost on me. You don't have to point it out again. What will we say to each other when the needle goes in? tell that we just roughed the friendship up. As we leave, I turn to you, ask how it feels to be immune. You know what I mean, a bit too much. What will we say to each other when the needle goes in? What will we be to each other if the world doesn't end? What will we say to each other? What will we be to each other?
I'm telling you, I'm getting all emotional here because of that particular song. I feel like that is the anthem of the past year, if not the upcoming year, 2021. Mm-hmm. Jensen McCray, you are amazing. We appreciate you as an artist and all of the things that you are doing right now. Of course, we'll be there for you every step of the way to play your music on the air and to try to get the word out.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, my pleasure. We are The Independent, 88.5
FM. 5 FM, KCSN, and KCSN HD1, Northridge, Los Angeles. KSBR and KSBR HD1, Mission Viejo. A service of California State University, Northridge, and Saddleback College. Member-supported public radio. Streaming on the web at 88.5fm.org.